What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, I wanted to briefly answer a question from one of my viewers about a previous video that I did on labels and doing a data override on those labels. So I wanted to get that question answered. Basically, his question was, let's say I'm working with lines and I want to data override the lines, each of the lines, but I also want them to be rule based. Can I data override those lines? And the answer is yes. So let me show you how to do that. On your line layer, and before we get into that, I'm gonna actually do a brief synopsis of this method. And if you need me to go further into any of these, the lines, the points, or the polygons, you let me know in the comment section. But this is brief. So when you go to the lines here, double click on your line layer to bring up the properties, and you'll go to the symbology tab. Okay, symbology tab. And we have the single symbol, and then we have the rule base. Now, because this is the question in rule base, so we'll go to rule base. And once you've added all your lines, you added your lines in here, if you want to connect those rules to a specific field in your attribute table, all you need to do is double click on the line here. Okay. You double click on the line, and now if you want to do any kind of data defining, you need to make sure whether you're trying to override the parent symbol or the subset or child symbol. Right now we are in the parent symbol, and the only thing that we can data override is the width. Okay. And so if we set a width, it will affect everything under this parent symbol. But if we want to go individual, piece by piece, we need to select the child under here. So we'll select the child symbol, and we'll see that we get so many more options to do a data override on. Okay, whether it's color, stroke width, offset, whatever you want to connect to in your attribute table. And remember, like I showed you in the other video, if you want to see what inputs you can do, you just press the data override button, go to description, and it'll let you know expected input, and it'll let you know what the expected input is and the valid input types. All right, so that is basically it for that rule-based thing. Let's go ahead and jump over to the single symbol. It's the same thing with the single symbol. There's a parent symbol, and then there is a child symbol. Of course, with the parent, this is like a umbrella effect. You set the width, and everything under that parent, that width will be modified to whatever you change this to. But if you want to specify a specific child, you go to the single symbol and you get your other override options for single symbols. All right, let's jump over to the points, point layer, same thing. You got your parent, you got your child. Point layers, you can change the size and the rotation of the parent. If you go to the child, you get all the options here. All right, you even have some shapes in here you can change to. And you can actually, if you bring a shape in with your or a SVG in with your attribute table, you can actually link that here. Let's see, let's jump over to our polygons. Same thing guys, keep it short and simple. Parent, child. Of course your parent doesn't have any kind of modifications you can do to it, but the child here, you can modify the color, whatever, the stroke color and the width. Just the idea of something you can use this for, let's look at this polygon layer attribute table. So let's say if we had the state names, right, and we wanted to look for all the states that have the letter M at the beginning, and we want to turn those states blue, right? we would create another field called maybe color, and we would connect that color. We'll come out here to our polygon layer here, and we will go into whatever the simple field is, and we will connect the field color, whatever that color is in your attribute table here. We'll come here, go to our field type, and we will look for whatever that name is, or whatever that equation is, or that for that field that we've created. And we'll be able to connect that and look for those specific things in those polygons. And you can also do that with the rule-based polygons. Put your rules in, whatever you want to look for, and then specify with the overrides if you want to. But that is all for this video. If you have any questions or comments, or you need me to go into further detail into any of these three, let me know in the comment section. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.